Thank you very much, Tom, for your kind introduction. So, nowadays, control system development within the automotive industry is evolving rapidly due to the increased regulatory pressure, shorter time to market, and increased control complexities, together with the evergreen cost reduction. All those points translate much more complex control system and additional degrees of freedom in the optimization of the operation parameters. Therefore, virtualization becomes mandatory throughout all the development process to minimize the need of prototype builds and reduce costly and time-consuming experimental testing, resulting in the earlier needs of accurate plant models when often experimental data are not available. Models allows controls and calibration engineers to move the design and tuning work much earlier in the development process, and thanks to their intrinsic low-cost parallelization capability, promise to consistently shorten the lead time for DOEs and optimization. Going more into the topic, probably most of you know that the control of a modern diesel engine requires around 15 control parameters to be optimized per each operating condition to minimize competing targets such as emission, fuel consumption, and noise. So, millions combinations are theoretically possible, and they are normally evaluated by means of long and expensive experimental DOEs. So it results immediately clear how the possibility to run at least part of this work on a virtual test bench could dramatically reduce the time and cost of the engine calibration. PowerTech and the eCube group of Politecnica di Torino developed robust methodologies for virtual calibration using fully physical engine models in GT Suite, as reported in those publications. The fast running models developed in GTs are a powerful tool for virtual calibration, as they can be real time using the GT Power XRT solver, and they can accurately estimate brake specific fuel consumption and combustion noise thanks to the fully predictive gas exchange models and fully predictive combustion models like the IPALS. This one can also work in combination with the Zeldovich model to accurate estimate NOx. For what concerns SUIT, though, the output of the built-in GT Suite model cannot be used for quantitative analysis, as the SUIT formation and oxidation are strongly 3D phenomena that cannot be addressed with 0D and 1D approaches. In previous work, an air-to-fuel ratio constraint was used instead, but as we will see in this presentation, data-driven approach provides much better results. In order to pursue this target, we joined forces with Modelway, a Politos spin-off born company, focused in developing data-driven modeling and control methodologies. Modelway's approach has been applied to several automotive applications, both in powertrain and vehicle dynamic domains, improving performance on conventional approaches. A few examples of application are the real-time side-slip angle estimation for onboard diagnostic and the onboard estimation of engine-out torque and engine-out NOx. So, the aim of the work is to address the problem of SUIT in virtual calibration by integrating data-driven models in GT. The data-driven model, in fact, could benefit of GT outputs, which can be also non-measurable quantities as independent variables, promising to reduce the amount of data requests, improve robustness, and increase quality, as we proposed in this SAE CO2 conference presentation. Practically speaking, the two models will receive as input the engine calibration parameter values as a set point of the virtual actuation, the virtual actuators placed in the model, like the injected mass, the angle of start of injection, and the position of actuators like VGT and EGR. The GT Suite model will then compute and generate various output as brake specific fuel consumption, noise, NOx, temperature, and so on, and what is needed for the data-driven model, as for example combustion-related parameters, but also in cylinder concentration, temperature, turbulence indices, and so on. Then the results of the two models